Let's get a call from Queen. Oh, God. Queen. Oh! No ace! No ace! No check! Come on. Ah, fuck, dude. Nine! Oh, man, what a beautiful turn there. Nut turn for us. I'm currently chatting with a couple of guys in the chat, so. Bible crump. Bible thump. Yeah. The problem is that my internet crashed. So we only have, like, medium internet now. And it's not good enough to stream, but good enough to play. So I just grind out these tables. We also have a deep run over here. Over here we are 3 of 13. With 434 top and 12 spots paid. Might be in the money here. Ace queen versus 4s. There's a 4 on the flop. And I mean, check on river 3 outer. Because we block a check. Nope. Man, chat is pretty funny here. We just talk. Like, this will not be live stream. So this is exclusive content on my YouTube channel. Where I play these deep runs out. And you know, we also have this over here where we are 11 of 20 minus on my last three tables. I'm not gonna grind much today. Internet is down and it's just annoying as fuck if you're not streaming. So yeah. There's another player down here and we're down to 5-3 tables, guys. We're 14 of 27 that one, guaranteed $61. We get a letter if one more person knocks out bus up to 70, which is kind of awkward. But after that, man, 5-3 tables, that's where the money starts to matter. Over here we have ace king, and maybe we're on the money here. He, yellow Nokia gets in his last couple of chips with the 8-9, and looks pretty dead in the flop. He needs to check or 7. Check on the river now. Nope. GG, we're on the money in that one, guys. Have a quick look at the payouts, where we are guaranteed $40, playing for 434. Let's get it. Last time we were in the FT, we got 9th. Let's do a little bit of a better job today. We hope the ace king gonna be checking it back here on the flop. It's a really bad one. And just going to fold the turn. Blind just went up, guys. We're down to 9 big blinds. Gets rough. Tens! Tens now, let's go. Come on. Come on, baby. We will be all in here. If he champs in some way, of course. Alright, definitely all in now. Come on, get the open jam. Open jam is 7th, dude. Make it happen. Oh shit, team. Easy jammy was the 3x. He will call with 8s and we hold. That's the plan here. Come on. Oh my god, come on. We can still be ahead versus Sam here. Hold! Hold! No! Oh, all the time deep in tournaments, man. Classic. Classic stuff. Losing 2 flips, man. Oh. Fuck, man. You just check out this insane hand we just played here. What in the world? What in the world did he just do? He opens ace to suited, we defend 8-7 suited, pretty standard, and check jam the flop here, and he calls with ace deuce of spades. Should we have none in the FT, 7 versus ace 9, there's a 9, 7's had less chips, so we get our first, oh, he makes it straight though. Damn it, never ladder. So guaranteed $50, playing for 400. Let's get him in, final 2 tables of the day we have going right now. Right. Maybe I upload this entire thing and don't even edit it, guys, and we'll just talk through. Maybe we have to chat. Right, Peter's sweating us on Stars of R here. Man, the team is together. Everybody is hyped. Let's get some scores in, team. Alright, H3 suited. We will open here and call over here. We will open and call him if he champs. Look at that booty. Let's get some euros together here. It's a pretty nice hand before the jam, and I check it's 3-bet out of 7%, man. I will jam this. We haven't covered as well. We can apply some pressure to a stack. Yep, there we go. There we go. Got it through. Pretty sweet. Gonna open here. And gonna open this on the FT as well. Seeing 4 of 9, 20 bigs, we can abuse pretty, can get abused pretty hard, but you know, what can we do? Still have to open the ace check. Big blind defense, pretty good flop here. Gonna c-bet and call. If he decides to jam, because he has a lot of jams here, just calls it. We should have bet like slightly bigger on the flop to like be able to jam the turn now. But I think we just, I mean, he gets an ace queen out of stuff free, 8-7, he gets another flop, so we just have the best hand. I think we just rip it. But we take down up to 55k, and we took down with the 4-5 down here with the double barrel. Actually, we shouldn't have folded DS5 because he was so short, that's a little mistake there. So yeah, we're 2 out of 18 now over here, as well as 4 out of 9 on the FT. Queen Jack gets it in versus sixes, that's a queen. No, we would have scooped it as well. No. Actually, we would have lost. All good. But I'm not sure if he would have gotten in the hand. Probably just folds when you open many champs. But maybe you re-champs. Whatever, we move on. 2 out of 17 there, guys. There's like around 700 euros up top. Would be a pretty good score because it's euros. Let's see a good flop here with the check 7. We could like squeeze as well, pre. But I think check 7 flops a little bit too good. Like if we had like ace 3, I would definitely squeeze it on the spot. It'd be 2 out of 17, 8 of the moolah. He doesn't want to call it super wide. And I think he isn't like super strong here usually. So yeah. We have a race and all in the FT. Ace 8 dominates ace 5. We just need to fade some hands. Just a 4 out of 5, we need to fade here. And just like that, we make our first letter on the final table. We are guaranteed 55-30 now. Yeah, I do think that I'm not at it, let's just like talk through it if it keeps on being interesting. It's an interesting flop here. We will have a lot of check raises here. Check 7 is like kind of a good candidate, but then again it's a little bit too wide, so we're just gonna give it up. And fold this to an open jam. And he loses the hand, which is awesome for us, you know, we want him to be short. Because look at that booty, that's the biggest right now, 45 euros. With the king queen, I think we can just flat it here. Oh, the big man champs it here for 8, and he opens. I think he shouldn't fold like super much here. And there's the call. Pretty good flop for the S10 of clubs, man. They're flipping it on the flop, and he gets there. That's another ladder, guys, just like that, we guarantee 67 bucks. Let's make this day profitable. It was only a short session today, so we... I played many tournaments, so not busted many either. Just gonna give it up down here with the king queen. But a7 on the final table. If he champs 6, man, do we ISO? That's quite interesting here. I mean, the 5-euro knockout doesn't, or $5 knockout doesn't matter much here anymore. But yeah, no, we just fold to the 3x for sure. Oh, he's getting in. Hopefully, millionaire champs and he folds. And you know, we want him to be shot, man. I want that booty. I want that booty. Oh shit, oh shit, I would have won a good turn. I mean, the click on the flop can be like 7, but can also just be a bluff, obviously. Ace queen now. This would be a 3-bet champ versus all of these guys. He 3x's it again. He has a big stack, he wants to abuse people. It kind of gets... Oh, now we will definitely rip it. I mean, this is a dream spot. Easy champ for us, guys. We pick up 20k if they fold. That's increasing our stack by a lot. Let's get a call from Queen. Oh, God. Queen. Oh! No ace! No ace! No check! Oh, shit! Oh, shit! We suck out on aces! Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Boom! In the chip lead now, guys. In the fucking chip lead now, baby. Let's get the aggression on. No, not that one. Damn. Oh, I would have scooped it. We would have scooped it, looped it. Can I finally say that he's unlucky? Can I throw something that is nice? Nah. We got another ladder, though. And it's break time, guys. We're getting 82 bucks up top now. Awesome dude over here. Gotta give him some props, man. You know, he takes the huge beat and it's just okay about it. Nice. Alright, we're back from break. Let's get it, guys. 1 out of 6 here on the final table with $434 up top. Yeah, let's win those two tournaments, guys. Have a profitable end here. There's the call. Ace deuce was 4-5. Ace deuce, I mean, decent call with these guys behind. We could have called with the queen 8 as well. And would have scooped it, actually. But ace deuce takes it down this time. GG. Wow. That seems kind of ridiculous. Alright, that means we're up to 110 bucks guaranteed. Have another short look at the payouts, guys. 110 guaranteed, then 150, then 221. So, like, right now, letters are kicking in. Let's get it. So sick. Big shout out to Peter and Ace of Face here. Lurking the entire time, actually. And just sweating me. Awesome. We got the walk with the check 3. That's pretty, pretty damn cool. Right now, actually, we can go into depth strategy here because I'm not editing this much. But we just, obviously, we are abusing these guys. If you could ISO this, man. 8 bigs. I think I like my spot a little too much here to give him. This might be too tight. He looks pretty raggish. This might be too tight, but it's not bad for us when there's a short stack on the table. You know, we can abuse these guys a little bit more. So I think it's a close spot here. If like there was more guys being short, I think we can call wider there. Yeah. Let's see what we can do. This could have also been a 3-bet. I don't mind folding it, otherwise we threw in a lot here. There's the jam out of the big blind for 28, a lot of chips. Usually that's just ace king here, but you know we're playing 5-handed, so maybe it's something else as well. Takes it down this time. Boom, the queen check suited up here in the 330 euro PKO. And got flatted here from. I want to play part with him once more. I want to get that booty up. Here we're also opening the ace 5 off. Pretty good flop. He gets ace king and priest, so we're going to queen king 9 because everything else we beat right now. So we want to be putting out a king 9, I mean. So we want to put out a big bet here. Some like 2-6-1-5. We get led into a pot, we just fold. He snaps it off. Gonna bet the turn again. Maybe just jam here. He's never folding to pair here. Oh man, big pot here. He pots it and then. I think I would just bet big here again. A7 versus queen 10. And A7 takes it down, guys. Another ladder, and we take it down there on the turn with the queen check. Too bad, but we can't check it there. And that means we are 1 of 4, guaranteed 150 bucks up top. Over here we can come in for the squeeze, which is interesting, but I think we just call once more. Nice flop here. We will be all in versus him. We'll just call that. I'm never folding here if it gets all in pre now. Oh shit. Just gonna call again, no spade in the river please. Thank you. It's not the best river to get action on, but I think we should just rip it in. A9 gets us in. And flops a straight. No 9 for another ladder, guys. Or diamond. Boom, there's the diamond. So bad, too bad. We get it in here. We only do this to one hand. Boom, team. Holy shit, what a bad call on this end. Got him. Got him. We are chip leading this one now as well. Got the booty. I'm gonna open the queen 3 because we're getting close to money. We're gonna start applying some pressure here. And just see how they react. I mean, he seems pretty loose. Even the fish tag, actually. Not bad. So up here, check these guys even out. Take down with the queen deuce. And yeah, hopefully we can just win it with the deuces. We take it down. Awesome. We have a really good spot here, guys. We have 2 out of 4 guaranteed 150 bucks. And down here, we have a good stack as well, playing for 700 euros up top. Keep the aggression going again, like he's the only guy that can abuse us, these guys are like kind of fucked him. And we get clicked here, obviously just have to call with any two for the pure odds. And I will check it back here, he checks the flop, which is interesting. We'll call the bet here on the turn as well, I think. I think we just check though. He says like all the kings, queens, checks and tens, so we don't want to bet. And he bets pot in the river. He bet pot last time with top pair, I think we just let it go here. We just let it go there. Seems like maybe it's a mistake there, but I don't know. Feels awkward to call. Maybe just hit like aces with the ace of hearts. Something like that. I don't know if that was even possible if the ace of hearts was out there. We have to call it with the ace 3 for the booty. Hold it. No king, no 7. Ah, ace. Damn. Gonna raise this one small here with the 8-10. Just see how he reacts. And gonna fire out one bet here on the flop. With our gut shot. And we have the diamonds. As well. We just take it down up to 1k. Nice. No, he is all in now. And he calls. Hold nines. The booty. No. Rip booty. He open champ 16 here, man. I think we just have to ice the sevens. That's just a small pocket pair too often. He champs the cutoff, you know. Hold. Big hold here. No. Come on, man. He flips deep in tournament. Seven. Yes. Oh, my God. I just lost my pillow in the back there. Boom. Holy shit, guys. Holy shit, man. The two out on the river. Sick. That means we're up to 221 bucks. And we face a 3x here. Gonna defend check 9 in position. And give it up on the flop. Now we have 50 bigs there. 20 bigs to our left. And king queen here. I think we want to raise call here. Blind versus blind, king queen just a little bit too strong. Over here we defend the big blind. Let's check it. Pretty good flop here for us. He checks it back. I will lead 2 times here on the big side. Not in that river, just gonna check that river. That's a horrible river to be bluffing. We lose to his queen, yep. I will call here on the flop. It's not interesting. Check you. I mean, it's just a turn. Ah, 6 is really bad. 6 is a really bad river. 6 is a really bad river. We lose now to 6-7. And 7-9. And 6-4. All hands that he bets on the flop, I will give it to him. Obviously, we can still be just behind. Good shot here at the $40 booty. I think we raise him big here. Like, this is a huge 3-bet, but with this bounty in the big blind, I think it's fine. I would also like put out a huge 3-bet with the bluffs here. Any folds, take it out. Take it down with the 7s as well, we have 3-handed there. Let's see if flop here with the queen 8. And he leads pot again, alright, at this point he gets the fish tag. So I just had to make the note there, we fold here. We defend the big blind with the 9-6. Just gonna check fold here, my gut shot, if he bets big, if he bets something like 800, might peel one and bluff later. We also raise the ace 8 here on the button and take it down. We two are like not super even. That's a little bit too big for me to call. If you had like a gacha and overcard, like we can play differently, but not there. Get a walk with the check 3. I appreciate that one, team. Gonna fold the 5-2s. Look at this. He's in the big blind now and pretty much all in, so it will be interesting here. Let's see what hand we get. Threes. I would just 3-bet champ here, I think, for 40. It's unlikely he wakes up with the pair. And yeah, I think it's just fine to champ 40 here. Maybe I go too crazy for a bounty again, but bubble as well. He just wakes up with 10s. 2 big blinds and 10s. And we are dead. It's pretty ridiculous. It's pretty ridiculous. How does he have 10s in that spot? Gonna review that one though. Let's view him up to check 10. 3 of the money here, we can apply pressure on all of these guys because we have everyone covered on my table. But we got 3-bet here. Check 10 off, man, that's just not good enough to call here. If he calls though, I would call as well. He champs. 5-6 here, gonna limp blind best blind for 15. We could actually, this is actually close to a jam here, especially on a fine table where there's like obviously close to zero ICM for him, but there's just a like it's an extra little bit of pressure that you don't want to get it in like too light. So we see about our gut shot here, I think that's perfectly reasonable. And I think I'll fire out one more bet here on the queen. It's a good card. Just makes it generally tough for him to call with the deuce or three again. And if he calls again, we can still fire on a four and an ace. I'll just check it here on the five. I mean, if this was like an eight of hearts, we could talk about jamming. I think we just want to check here. Maybe he still has the ace three. Hopefully he has it. Yep, he has the ace three. Nah, he should jam ace three pre, so probably, like, I don't know, 6-3, okay. Nice one, the river there. And we get aces now. Gonna min raise, hopefully he rips it in. No, they've been just folding to too many of our button opens. Damn it. King queen suited here, will be a call. Alright, come on. It's a pretty good flop here, he's down to 3.2k, guys. That is a good flop. Let's hold. We have the same hand! So cute, he says. I mean, that was a standard double. I think I like the double barrel a lot there. Too bad here. How does he have queen, queen, again? Couldn't he just have king jack, king 10, king 8, king 7? All these other bullshit. 14 suited here. Alright, we get the fold. Ace king now. I have a 3 bet call here for 40. We've been really aggressive versus him. He might get tilted a little bit and goes for the light 4 bet champ. Chip, you will never hear, you will hear this, like, maybe delay, maybe watch this video one day, man, but thanks for the follow. So, yeah, we're coming in with the big 3 bet. They're not super huge, obviously. 2.5x in position, I mean, it's pretty standard, actually. Oh shit, guys, limp pot 3-7, easy life. Gonna be putting out a bet here on the flop. He calls. Gonna bet big here on the turn. It snapped, make a boat on the river, and gonna fire out again. 28k here. Over here, really bad flop for his king, gonna check it back. And gonna bet here. Boom, that's some value team, we're on the chip lead now. Gonna check it back here, and check the river as well. It's not a great river, the 9. Yep, fuck me, dude, fuck. And easy jam with the check 10 now. Alright, we're flipping. That's a 10, no ace. No ace. We are heads up now, guys. We are heads up. We are officially heads up in this one. Boom. And even get another 5 euro KO. A $5 KO. That means we guaranteed 292 bucks playing for 434. That's a big heads up match here. We should have an edge, man, but we will find out. We will find out. Down here, he's all in, and this guy tanks forever. Oh, he just champs the first hand. All right. This would be nice for me, though, with the king jack. Yeah, I think that's pretty obvious. Champs 13 bigs with a booty. We just have to ice that one. Alright, come on, 40% here. No ace. No ace. Yes, guys! That is good stuff. We 3 exit here, and hopefully he champs it this time again. He's pretty wild heads up, man. Yep, easy call with 8s. And what the fuck? What? What? 8! Wow, that's so unlucky! What? That is so unlucky! That is... what? No! What in the world? How does he wake up with king's heads up and we have 8s? And he just chanted before, I thought I would see like deuces here or something like that. Damn. Oh my god, the coolest heads up. This is a $140 heads up match, guys. Like, this is big. Just keep the up. Just update in the chat there. Alright, we're on with the ace-9 now. Take it down. I'll call one bet here on the turn. Man, these rivers are always bad, man. I always feel he gets down the river. Alright, take it, sir. We got a walk here, let's make a comeback. King 3 for 13, I jam. Alright, let's make the comeback, guys. Let's get that comeback. Man, he's folding a lot, dude. He just knows the jam and the fold. This will be also jam here for 15 with ace 5. Into a 6. Oh god. Come on, big card and no club. Wow, pretty unfortunate heads up there, like super unfortunate heads up. GG, we cash for slightly over 300 bucks in that one. 324 bucks and 80 cents to be exact. Alright. Alright, let's get this one, guys. We're sitting in 2 out of 11. 2 out of 11. 2 out of 11. 44 euro min cash and 336 plus KOs for first, so like 700 euros are waiting up top. I'll actually open up the other table here on the side. Check 9 here. I'm a bit frustrated that this king hand, it's like the heads up, man. Too bad. Too bad. Just give that one to him. I'll quickly open up Shark Scope and get some information on these guys. While we're at it. 10-8 off, I'll open. Let's open this. This is stats blocked, but he looks pretty raggish. And we're gonna see bet here. It's a pretty good hand to be see betting here. Once again, it's kind of nice when you see bet and you don't have just complete air, but you have like a gut shot and two overcards. It's a really sweet combination. Man, a lot of people have the shark scope blocked on it. Let me take it down. So this is the last tournament here. Fold this one. And I get a call from my brother, guys, one second. Eine Sekunde mal, ich muss mal ganz kurz was kommentieren hier, weil ich nehme gerade was für YouTube auf. Alright, guys, this time I'll forbid him, man. This is like the fucking third time he three-bets us from the button. So, I'm going in here with the ace-5. I mean, go for the four-bet fold this time. And yeah. Hopefully he just folds. We hand for hand now. Nope, he jams it. Alright, got wrecked, got wrecked. Okay. Okay. Damn, guys. What a shitty call with ace-check, guys. I don't know, man, I just want to experiment with like bluffing these spots, and that's just like a bad call with H-check, I think. You can have queen-check, you know, all the two pairs, all the sets. He just said H-check, like, that's just such a bad bluff catcher. Like, this is a spot where I will just bubble here by jamming king-queen. This is just a spot where I will bubble. This might be even a flat given the bubble, but then one of these guys just can jam, nah. Come on. I don't know, man. Like, jamming is fine. I keep it open super wide here for sure. And we block ace, king, ace, queen, kings, and queens. Alright. So, yeah, hopefully, you can make some chips back, guys. Like, man, check out our chip graph. Holy fuck, it just goes downhill. No, pick the flop. Bluffed it off. Classic Buehlero. Gonna be C-bet calling here. You would jam like king, jack, plus king, queen of clubs. Let me take it down a decent amount as well. 20k again. Recovering a little bit from bluffing. From bluffing it off here. I mean, the good thing about like the ace check bluff catch is that you block queen check, you know? But that's about it.
Let's get this thing back on. All right, there we go. Ah, team. Still in the bubble for this 45 euro min cash. I want it. I want it. That is the other table, by the way. Look at this guy being so short, man. You can apply some pressure on him now. He's sitting out. He just doesn't want to mess with it anymore. 3xing is here super weird. Like, no idea what that is. Maybe his king. Yeah, probably his king, something like that. But yeah, I'm not a fan of just open champ this spot. So if we get a walk here, but it's pretty much impossible with the Brigetti. Pretty much impossible with him. This guy, like this shotgun, the other table, he's just snap folding like everything. Come on, give him like a bad hand once. Check it here. But we even block his bad hands, lol. Actually, that's the first time I realized that you block other people from having bad hands as well. Weird. Alright, gonna check it. Not gonna blast it off here. I think we chain the king to suit it. Because of ICM. So it's a good spot to be 3-betting here. Nah, I think we need to be 1-3-bet that one. He just opens like so much garbage there on the button. Take it down, guys. 21k. I just can't be tied in the bubble, guys. Just can't be. It's not happening. It's not happening. Alright, we're recovering a little bit. Now we got checks here. We were 3 with him again, and this time called it for the jam. Alright, we raise it here and hope one of these guys rips it in. That would be so sweet. Like, they were just like jam 8s here. We call, get the booty. We also have an all-in over here. And a call, guys. Queen check versus ace 4 blind versus blind. No spade. And we are in the money. Boom. Alright. So these guys can't champ wider now, which is actually good when the bubble busts that way. Yep. Alright, easy call with checks, guys. Let's get the booty. If he overcalls here, we might still call. Oh my god, guys. Come on. Check. Check. Not like this. Come on. Down to 10 bigs here. But we made the money at least, getting 45 euros, but you know, we wanna get that bounty there, and he champs way wider than just queens, kings, and aces, obviously. Unfortunate to run in that one. Get the Bible thumb in the chat. Alright, take that one down, guys. Gonna fold here. So just close the 8-8 there. One time check. Yeah, just like it sucks really hard when he wakes up with queens. Speaking of waking up with queens, guys, queens was a check. Oh shit, oh shit. We like to suck out there from the H-Jack because we will make a letter at 6th place, and that means right now we only need to see 2 more knockouts and lose that guy. Probably. We have 7s here, this will be all in. If he champs, we will call. We have him covered as well, which is pretty sweet. Queen 9 versus 7 to suit it, he asks for the bounty. And here's a head on the flop, needs 7 to do some river load, but doesn't get there. And 7s will be a 3-bet champ here, pretty easy and simple. Let's hold it, guys. Let's hold it. Come on. Yes! Up to 20k, guys. Important double up. We're back in the match here. And Deuce 9 off will be a champ? I'm not sure, man. His bounty is decently sized here. But I'm not sure if he's champ any 2 here. Like, this is just like Deuce 9 off. Come on. Not sure, guys. Actually, I think I will lay it down. I think I will lay it down. Right, we wouldn't have gotten the spot anyhow, but yeah. Fourteen suited here. In some interesting spots, just folding now.
Man, I need a glass of water. I need a glass of water here. There's the flat again. Christine making some weird flats here. Yes, was a profitable session actually today. Already. Let's get a bink on here and win a couple of hundred. Oh, that water's great. Feels good, man. I will open this one and call a few jams. With the booty equity, will be a easy raise call. Even though he has been shown, like, he's been flatting a lot of the small blind, and it just seems like, I know, a fishy regular here on most part. We could check a back or bet here. I think we want a bet on the smaller side here. We get caught by king, queen, queen 10, a check, you know, decent amount of hands there, but up to 21k. Alright, king 8 here. Gonna be calling. There's a 2.5x. Couldn't we just have the king and diamonds? That would make our decision on the flop way easier. Gonna check it back here. It's a tough spot, man. I'm not sure where I'm at. Most likely we just check it down this to an ace high, but sometimes a king high can be good here. It's 7s. Alright. That makes sense. Oh, king 6 suited, guys. Easy jam now. With the booty equity. And even without that, it's just a plus V jam here for 8 bigs, obviously. Huge plus V. Take it down. Queens now, let's hope we don't run into kings or aces. Let's hope that doesn't happen here. Come on, rip it in, Christine. Give me that booty. Like, if he rips it, then he can ISO. Like, if we saw him, like, I think he was the guy who ISO'd earlier with ace 2, is pretty wild. No. Not this time. I think we raised the 8-9 as well. Because like now he's so short that we just want to get in with any 2 versus a stack. And my table is surprisingly tight here actually. Up to 23k. 3-10 will be a card here as well with the booty equity. Let me just pray be alive. Just kept left with 9-10. Got punished by ace X. Alright, obviously just folding, not defending here with these guys. Well, here you have some action, just opens into his stack, he goes for the 3-bet, obviously can't 3-bet white here on the button, with him being that short, just takes it down. I don't mind this as a 3-bet, he broke white into his stack, so I really don't mind this too much here. Let's go a little bit bigger than usual. Maybe this is a little bit too obvious and we should just flat. But alright, we take down again. 25k. We're stacking up here nicely, guys. If you look at our chip graph, you know, if they're punting it there with the bluffs here and we're down the hole, we're getting back up there. We were at 40k at one point. Damn. I should have opened 9-5 again. He has to call with any 2 here. Yeah. Come on, hope he holds. He has only 2 outs to hit because we blocked the 5. Alright, we would have lost it. Obviously nice to see that, being results orientated. check 10, we open. Once again, I have to call him still, because he's up to 10 bigs now, but right at the edge, where we can still make really wide calls for the bounty. If we start him like 16, I think, he's definitely out of the range. With like 13, it will be really close. And yeah. This is a spot where we'll see, but we have the 10 of spades. We can barrel on a queen, an ace, and you know, we just get a lot of folds from him anyhow. So you put out the c-bet here and take it on once more, guys. You're just stacking up like crazy. 27k, man, just like playing simple poker, c-betting and stuff like that. I think we fold here for 10. I don't want to lose 8k right now. Then we're like in push fold, like not push fold now, but like we lose a little bit of our playability. So 9-3 isn't great, but like we could think about, like, I would call a min raise, but 2.5x I would fold to pretty much here. Hopefully he just folds or limbs. I take a fold here, man. You know, just give me another part. We're just cruising. Let's continue. Oh shit, those guys are getting it in here. Katamundix all in for the FT bubble, maybe. Really bad floppy for us, we're just gonna give it up. Let's watch this hand a little bit. So this guy raised, he called, and this guy re-raised, just really small. Gotta go with it now on the turn here. Alright. Before the 3-8 suited. Let's see what happens here. Check 10. Wow, he open folds. 2-7 takes it down with the river. Pretty sick. 2-7 of spades. With the win, he triples up to 9k, even quadruples up or something. So now we have 2 short stacks officially. And then we are there, and we are kind of even with a lot of these stacks now. Like, between 25k and 35k, there isn't that big of a difference. He's like way too tight here, it's pretty weird. This would be a race call versus him, obviously. There's a millionaire, man. We might go for a light 3, but like, we've been opening a lot here. It's a good flop here. Like, we are getting it all in here, for sure. I think we want to bet on the bigger side here. Protect our hand. If he raises us, we just get it in. He can have weaker 9s, 6-7, all these type of hands. I think we bet again here on the turn and then we check back the river. You think he will still call the turn sometimes with like a 5 and stuff. And weaker 9s obviously. And if you check, we have to call a big bet on the river, or he might check, and then we are kind of in an awkward spot when like a queen rolls off here. So by just betting the turn, I think we can make an easy check back on the river. But he goes for the min click re-raise. Oh god. I think I had gotta call this, but I would fold the river a lot here. But it's 4k, dude. No, I would give it to him. Alright. That's just an awkward spot, dude. I don't want to invest 4k more because, like, once we do, like, if you invest 4k more there. We are down to 12k and that's 15 bigs, but with 20 bigs I can still like raise fold more, and with 15 like it would be really tough for me to do that. That's just a really unfortunate spot, man. Maybe we just folded, like, we could have folded the best hand, but obviously I don't think like it's a spot where people bluff super often with a click there. But we don't know. We are playing on his side. It's a good flop for my range here, gonna check it. And put up one bet here on the turn now. It's like a 2.6. Actually, no, I would just give up. Ace King vs Queen Jack, blind vs blind. Ace King seems to double up. Yeah, I would just give it up here on the turn. We could lead and double barrel. But just like not super great there. Deuce 8, I would jam now with this bounty. Pro Jetty can open jam a decent amount here and obviously raise 4 to us a lot as well. Just tank again and open. Alright, take it, sir. We're struggling now on the 19 bigs. But not much I could have done with the ace 9, I think. We could, like, check the turn there. And then bet the river. But as I said, I didn't mind double barreling it. It's just weird when he clicks it like that. It's just really disgusting. We keep on the aggressive button open. It has been working out good. He's not defending big blind super wide, I feel. And we still have obviously shot at his bounty. Once again, a good flop. We will be c-betting here. Want to protect our hand a little bit and get some value from a 3. And a weaker 5, obviously. Alright, this is a card that we usually bluff. But since we have it, we'll just check it here. And check the river as well, on the 6. Because 6-7 got there, 6-4 got there. And he just floated us with King 8 of spades, which is reasonable in the flop there. Take it down. Taking it down. Peter, man, just sweating it, just sweating it. So sick. So sick. Alright, so 7 out of 8 we are here. Since Katamundix over here just cruising and getting the double ups and triple with the 7-2 suited. He's by far the shortest now. He's like really tired, man. I know. He's pretty good set, so. Yeah, maybe pocket fives, yeah. And I think we have to call this. It's 4k into 6k with the bounty, yeah. It sucks when he has that. Let's get a 5, guys. A 5! I don't think we can fold like any hand there, pretty much. It was a 6 big blind jam with the bounty on the 9. And it doesn't hurt my stack like super much to lose there, obviously it sucks. Easy jam with the check 7 now. That one is pretty obvious. I think like he's just too tight in these spots anyhow, so we can jam wider, but like check 7. Super standard even versus like a normal regular, but rip it in there. With this bounty, like we can jam so wide, it's just crazy. 5-9 suited now. That's what I mean with the 15 big blinds, which I don't like about it, is that we just have to fold here. Shit, we got the kings now, guys. Going for the raise here. Let's hope he jams it. Come on, we've been opening so much. Let's punish me this time, guys. Wake up with a good hand. Not a super good hand, though. Just a good one, you know? Not the best of hands, please. No! No action with the kings again. Ace and suited, I will call him. Yeah. I will fold to that, though. Whew, he's just so tight. It's crazy. Wow, sick. Dodge the bullet there, kind of. Man, these guys are making comebacks. It's pretty sick. We are 8 out of 8 now. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. King check suited, man. I think... it's close. Man, full chat, he opens here. I think I rip it. I think I rip it here. We're playing four-handed. King check suited on the button. 15. With fold equity versus the stack. Should be fine. Like, stacks are pretty even here if you win this one. Oh shit, millionaire. I don't like the tank. I don't like the tank. Oh. Nice, up to 19k, guys. It's an important win, man. 20 bigs. Stacks are so even, it's crazy. 20, 20, 26, and 30. I want to get them ladders, baby. I want to get them ladders. I want to make the FT here. Sucks if we punted, like with the Queen 7, I was talking about Prada, you know, I usually don't bluff there, it's just like, oh, I mean, we made an experiment, yeah, I mean, when people are calling us with H-Tag, it's obviously horrible. I think we jammed the King 5, versus a limp here. I don't think he's trapping, like, a super much here, I think he's more of the type that would raise, like, 2.2x instead of trapping. And King 5 doesn't flop that good, so, let's just take it down pretty a lot. Versus him, I'll raise it now to, like, 2.420, and fold with the Queen 6. I said, he's too tight in the all-in situation, so I think we just win out pre a lot here. And yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, we keep on stacking out, guys. We lose in the all-in situations, man, but we are playing, like, we're playing good poker. Whew. It's quite interesting, actually, man. I'm really focused into this match here, so I'm not even sure if I will edit this whole thing because I'm talking throughout, and it's just like, I don't know, maybe it's interesting for you guys to watch the analysis of these hands. Gonna raise the queen 10 here, get the call from the button. All right, interesting. See a good flop here. Ah, shit, dude. He's a tight guy, you know. He's a tight guy. We're gonna be c betting. It will be weird if he jams it here. Alright, he folds. Alright, but Sim, we just have to get it in. But we take it down. 27k again. 4 out of 8 now, actually. 4 out of 8. Because we have... Do we have more chips than him? Yeah, we do have. Not anymore after this hand, though. But yeah, not bad, guys. Not bad. Let's keep it going. 3x open, man. We give the fish tag now. I give the fish tag. He has good results, man. But... his players are just not adding up to that. Ace 4 will be a Chamaroni here. I'll fold if one of these guys open, actually. Just Just hasn't opened the button like that wide yet. I think we want to fold the ace-4 off. We will have 3 bets anyhow. Alright. I think it's fine to fold one here. Gonna fold this one as well. 25 bigs here. Blinds are going up in 4 minutes. Then we are down to 20 with our current stack. Alright, Pogetti, we're going for the 2 in a row here. Gets defended from the big blind. Gonna fold D3 off. Gonna lay it down. Pretty action-packed whole thing here, man. King 10 the big blind. I would call it 3x this time. This sounds a little bit too good. Blind versus blind. We call. I would also just call versus him and not jam. I mean, we have him covered now and he has a big booty. So there's some intents to get it in versus him. But yeah. I don't mind like actually raising it to like 3.2k. We have an all-in over here. They are flipping it. I mean, the queen or check to make the step close to the FT. Nope, but he wins. Goes for the limp jam this time. Kind of sucks to fold King 10 here. Sucks pretty hard. We could have just checked it. I just didn't want to give him like a free flop like that. This guy's all in for 8. We will be all in here with the queen check. Ace king, he's low rolls. And he has ace king as well. It's pretty sick. Come on, give me the jam spot, dude. I would call here with the queen check. Which might be a mistake. Yeah. Fuck me, dude. Fuck me. 13k to 20k, man. I just don't want to lose that, you know. We can do so much with my stack there. We can do so much with my stack. Ace-5 suited now. We don't have these guys covered. Otherwise, we could open jam this. I think now we want to raise it. It's so disgusting. I mean, actually, we can threw a jam here with Bulgetti. He's been, like, getting more aggressive now. He opened the button 2 times in a row, and then he also opened the cutoff last time. So, we'll open up our jam through a jam range versus him. Not versus these two guys. They haven't been too aggressive yet, but ace for suited definitely for near and open here on the button. Hopefully we take it down, but then suddenly we have those two guys covered again. Catamonix, man, just stacking up. He was so short and just wins the hands. I gotta fold it here. Damn it. Queen check suited, man. We just have to open again. Oh, I limped. Misclick. For the fans on YouTube. I just hope we can see a good flop here. Oh, that's a good flop. That's a good flop, guys. This is a good flop. We will be all in here. We don't have anyone covered, which sucks really hard. Because then we would have like so much equity if we get it in with our flush draw. So if we just get it in with like 10-9 of clubs, that would be sweet. We will put out a bet here. Because we can just, like, we can fold them off ace highs. So, yeah. I think we want to put out a bet here. Hopefully you just see a good turn there, you know. Just spiking a little club. I will not bet again here on the turn. I will just check it and pray for all our lords to the gods that the river is a club. Or queen or check, because then we can beat the eights. Yes. Nope, just checking it. Maybe he has 10 out of clubs. Maybe once in a blue moon, guys. It's one of the few hands we beat here on the river. Damn it. Now to 14k, guys. Maybe you shouldn't even bet off flush run to three people, but I think it's fine. Alright, let's defend the check 7, guys. All in over here, check 9 versus ace queen. Oh shit. Oh, he's dead, guys. That means we're on the FT bubble now, sitting in 7 out of 7. Yeah, hand for hand now. Weird, man, they only play 3-handed here. God, how are we down to 13k again? It looked so good for us. We had like 26k and then just like getting punished in some spots and suddenly short. 8-9 off will be a rip. It's Especially versus him. Alright, give him the fold. The other hand. Oh. Over here, 8-9 off, he folded. Now there's not too much action going on FD bubbles. They usually last pretty long. I mean, there's only me with 13 bigs in him. I mean, actually, people are not that deep here. FD Buehlero confirmed. Oh god, not like this, please. Not the FD Buehlero. Blinds are going up now. We are down to 10 bigs. Damn it. Ace 4 will be a jam though. Easy jam here on the button with the ace. Let's not see a call here. Just take it down. No, go up to 12 bigs and be happy about it. I mean, he can certainly call us fairly wide with our bounty, like, you know, like King 10. I think he should, King 10 he should call, I guess, with my bounty. I'm not sure if we want to flip it here. I'd rather just get it in good, guys. Alright, take it down. Taking it down, folding the check 3. Sick, man, I'm excited. Let's get the comeback, man, let's get the comeback. Shit, he's all in. FT hype? FT hype? Come on. Nope. Like, he is so tight that I wouldn't call him too wide here. Oh shit, the 3-bet off the big blind here. Oh, and the insta-stam. And the insta-call. Ace-king versus checks. Let's see an ace or king for the final table, guys. Come on. No, they chop it up. They chop it up. Not like fucking this. King's off will be a fold here by my blind. I will defend the big blind versus a race, though. Not versus a 3x. Just versus a min-race, I will see a flop. And go from there, blind versus blind. I mean, if you have a champ quite wide, but we don't want to call with the king deuce. We don't want to call. Alright, take it, sir. I would call with like king 8 there, king 7 suited. Tens now! Let's go. Let's get the double. Borghetti will open champ the button here, super wide. If he's a good player, which I think raising results wise, even though he made some weird plays here. He min raises, which shows some strength. Maybe, not quite sure what that is. Gonna be champing though. No other option for us with tens here. Ace 9 beats ace check over here, just makes quads. This guy's running like a fucking god. It's insane. Oh my god, is the Christine waking up or something? Wow, he raised folds. He raised folds. We're up to 17k. Holy macaroni, guys. This is pretty crazy. 14, man. Like, this guy is just like, he's cruising way too hard, man. Just makes, look at that hand. He just makes quad nines with the ace 9 versus ace check here. He just makes quads. Oh my god, it's sick. We're actually 6 out of 7 now, him being shorter. Our hand's already over. Wild, dude. Wild. Queen 5 beats him here. Ace 10 suited, open jamming it for 14. We could induce a little bit here, but if you just take it on pre, that's perfectly fine with me, man. Up to 90k would be nice. I think we even get called still right from him here. Like ace 8, I think he can call us with. Ace 2, like ace 9. Hold! Hold. Oh god. Yes, guys! Let's fucking go! Boom, important double up, just as I said, what he can call us with, man. 4 out of 7 now. Ah, and he champs it now, but actually fold ESM suited here because he is such an it. Because he is so tired, I'm gonna make the fold with ESM suited, I would have snapped it blind versus blind. And that means we are chip leading our table, which is awesome in the bounty tournament, guys. So, on the other table, we have 3 bigger stacks than me right now. Weird. But yeah, let's abuse the bubble a little bit now. This is such an important double. I mean, as I said, we can call this with the ace-8, which is probably a correct call. It's just unfortunate for him to make up with such a good hand and hold it as well. Let's get it. Let's get it. Ace-3 wins it over here, new hand. 7-10 will be good enough to jam. On the bubble, but not good enough to ice that one. Alright, let's hope the bubble continues, guys. Let's hope the bubble continues. Oh, what an important double up! Come on, let's get to the Pokerstars of Arbor. We've been struggling. I mean, you saw the videos in the past if you haven't done it. Like, check out like the 82 Bounty Builder Madness video, for example, where we, which is called Buehlero with 3 Elegiggle smileys on top. Ah, Pokerstars of Arbor, guys! yeah. Let's hope that doesn't happen today, because it looks good now. Check 7 suited. Gonna raise it here. Put the pressure on. We could almost, like, open charity for 24, because he... I mean, the bubble is just not that big, you know? It's, like, only a 17 euro ladder, so... Yeah, he 3-bets us, man. We have a really nice hand. I will get it to him, but it's a close one. It is a close one here. Just 3-bet the big blind, you know, and after that sack size, give it to him for now. A7, I will raise it up here. I'll raise fold versus him, actually. I just don't want to lose my stack here. Alright, alright. Two more folds, please. Two more folds. Now it's break time, actually. Oh, we got the call here from him. We fired a bet here on the flop. You know, he would call this with a king. Queen jack. And we take it down, guys. Up to 35k, and it's break time. Let's crush after break. I'm so hungry, by the way. It's 2 p.m. already. I haven't gotten lunch yet. But, you know, we'll ship this first and then get our well-deserved lunch. Stay tuned. Alright, back from the break here with the 7-10 and the bigger blinder. Bigger blinder, I don't know why I set that up weird. Kind of fold it though. Let's go screen. I mean, like she or he, whatever, has been like just chatting and like so tired. That is... Pretty weird for us to call. Here we will jam it. But spaghetti, we could 3-bet jam. I think, like, we saw him raise fold earlier on a similar spot, and I think he can have raise folds here. Easy jam blind was blind, obviously, versus the tight guy was 9-7 suited. Even versus something like the ace check, we have 40% here, and we are gladly, like, taking. Like, even like if we get it in here with 41%, like, it's fine. But we will just take it down pre most of the time. I'm gonna raise it here with the ace-5. Kind of sucks if we have to raise fold to him again, but... I think we just want to wait for a better hand if he 3-bets us, but he take it down, guys. 36, 66, 8. And watch his hand over here. Man, the table selection is just great for us right now. It would suck for us to be on the other table. We just have to be really tight, you know? Like, just imagine, we are like him at this table. He just can't do much, you know? He cannot steal or anything like that. I mean, obviously he will still, like... pretty decently aggressive, but it's just different when you have like shorter stacks that you can bully around. And you know, every time we jam it or something, we have also a shot at a bounty, and that is just great. Like every jam gets like so much better. You know, suddenly when you get in with 25% and have a shot at booty, it's not that horrible anymore. That's good always. It's always good. These two guys get shorter, he just stacks up a little bit. Whatever, doesn't affect us super much here. After fold to 4-3, I would call a raise though. If we raise it here, I would call. Blind versus blind, we can't call a jam. Take it. We have to keep on waiting for a good hand. Two-way pot actually. I could show what happened here. He puts out a bet in the river with the bluff and calls it kings. Alright. Now it's suitable to be a jam here. Also have a 3-way jam with him. I can't call the jam though. Especially not with my stack, you know. Just can't take the gamble here and lose 14 bigs and be down to 15 ourselves. But he gets some champs through here. Opening the check 9 on the button. Still not counting Christine here. If he had like 80k here, you know, we could ISO there earlier with the 8-7 suited. But obviously not with that stack. And back to our 36-6-6-8. Check 6 suited here is a close one. Table has been tied, I will open it. Table has been tied. Alright, I think we get punished. Every time I make like a move like this, where I know it's like it's pretty damn aggressive and it might be losing, we get punished, it feels. And yeah, we get punished hard there with the check 6 suited, which is obviously pretty aggressive. Like check 7 suited, totally opening that, but check 6 suited, it's aggressive. I know for handed on this table, it can't be that bad. Let's bet the other one. A6 and A7 chop it up. 8-5 off in the big blind. Can't do a call here. Man, sick bubble time, guys. Sick bubble. Last forever here. I kind of want to defend here. I think we have a post for edge versus him. So let's defend the 8-5 off and completely brick the board here. Just completely get the brickeroni on. Just like, blah. Doesn't get much worse than that board for us. Takes it. 3x open on the button from that sack size. Interesting to see. Would have loved a jam from him, just to see if he 3x folds a dam. Checks it back on the flop. Maybe some like 5c or 4s. And they should just open jam that. Queen 9, I think he called it off with 5s. Maybe ace jack. Ah, we can't see it, damn, that sucks. Would be really good input. Man, 9-3. I mean, it's pretty obvious when we raise it here, you know? Then again, we can look also pretty strong here. I think I go for min raise. But we don't get a spot anyhow. He just whips it again. Blinds went up. So those guys are even shorter now, sitting like 12 bigs. He opened and he defends it. This might be the hand if we make it to the FT. I think he will check jam it here a decent amount of the time. But he just folds it, obviously. Most of it. 10-3 suited here on the button again. Given how much they fold, I think we want to open. Just keep the aggression going. Yep. 3-bit out of the big blind here, takes it down. Check 3 suited, I have a fold this time. Oh, guys, it's a wild one. It's a wild one here. Like, pretty swingy, mix of emotions. We get a jam here, man. He got a lot of walks from him. I think that's how he maintained his stack as well. Actually, he didn't get that many walks now. I'm wrong. Oh, shit, we have to wait for the other hand. I was like, man, come on. Is it lagging now? 3k on the turn and a call. So Latino. It's pretty committed here. Interesting river at the jam and he folds. Damn, he is short now. He is short now. We got the check 8 here. It's kind of sucks here because we have to fold. But we get the Vogue. Finally a Vogue, man. He's been jamming so much there. Which obviously he can with the stack. And with our stack, if we had like a lot, once again, more chips, I think he jams a little bit tighter. Since we were hunting the booty more often. And there's an all-in, guys. This might be the final table. Ace 5 versus 5s. I guess you want to see a brick here and hope that 5s hold. Yep, that's the case. We like this bubble situation, guys. I will jam the 8-5 off here with the booty on the line. And him being tight. But we can't do anything versus a race but folding. So the bubble continues, guys. The final table bubble continues. Oh, we see a defend here. He hasn't been defending the big blind much at all. Maybe it's something like, I don't know, ace 8, ace 9. He's just tired of folding but doesn't want to get in pre and will like check jam it now on the flop or... Not sure what he had there, maybe queen 10 or something? Said he hasn't defending... I mean, we open jammed a lot into him as well, like there weren't many raises. He's pretty short now, sitting on like 8 bigs. He sits on like, after the send on 14. Thinks about calling. We have here, he opened and the big blind defense. This guy folds. And a c-bet. And a fold, alright. Deuce 9 of spades, just gonna be a fold here. Sadly. He gets a jam on the button. And the call with king queen has to call that one. So base check holds it. Yep, that's a hold. I like it. Now we have a shot at booty. He's shot in a bubble. Like the bubble stays alive or is maintained. I don't know what you say. We will be all in here with the H-Tag. If he opens and he champs, we will reach him. And we also just threw a champ this here with the H-Tag. He will open the button wide because of him. And yeah, we just have to champ this for 24 bigs. I don't really hope to get caught there actually. Because I don't really want to get in there. I think we call and fold to him here. 6k. Yeah, with the booty, I think we have to call this. But fold a few rejams. Yeah, but maybe that's a mistake because now we get 2-1. Yeah, that's a mistake here. Maybe I should have just rejammed because like with that hand, we have enough equity. Wow, he hits the 8 on the turn though, so he stays alive. God, so sick. So sick here. What is this FT bubble, man? Damn it. Alright, ace 9 suited. I think. Nah, we just raised again. Do we have to call him now though? Like, this is close versus him. Yeah. Alright, we can't get the phone now. I would have called in the end properly. Yep, we would have been right. God damn it. But we would have lost it. We make the final table, guys. But I would have called him here with the ace 9. We make the FT. Kind of sucks there with the fives that he rechamps. Otherwise, would have actually hit the three, I think. So, phew, I guess good on us. Finally, make the FT, guys. These are the payouts for it. It's been a while. So, 60 euros, then 84, 112, 170, 224, and 336 plus the bounties. And the winner doesn't not only get their bounty, but also his own. Let's hope for a king, for a 10 here. Damn. Wow, we double scooped the whole thing. But we get the ladder. We get the ladder. Which I guess we take that. We're up to 84 euros guaranteed now. So, not a bad session here for us. We'll be profitable. But you know, I want to win big here. I want to win this thing. Because like in the end, you get all the bounties and your own. Which will be like 300 euros or something. Let's get a Fanta King 5. I think we just give it up here with the King 5. Like, even his draws have so much equity versus us, because I don't think he would open 3-4 there. Maybe 3-4 suited though. So, like, besides that, you know, like 7-8 and all this stuff has good equity. And it's just tough for us to continue on, like, many turns. If you had the King of Clubs, I would never ever fold there. We took the disgusted deal for the run good. We are by far now last base in chips here. So we have some easy decisions, like ICM doesn't apply much to us. We just hope that they bust each other out, we get a ladder, and hopefully we can, you know, just double up here. With 44k, we have a lot of possibilities again. But hopefully that's soon, you know. Since we'll be a little bit boring now, we only have to raid one table, and I mean, maybe these guys are going to rumble a little bit here. Flats the button. So that's already one thing to notice. I can't Mundix didn't overcall here. So maybe it's just like a little bit of a weak regular. Because he doesn't like he doesn't call defend the big bomb wide enough. We'll see. All of these guys are like decently solid stats here. You know. So I have a couple of hands on them. Seem to be regulars here. Yeah, once again he folds like that. Interesting. Would have been a good turn for us if we were in the hand, but we are not, so we don't care. We don't care. Oh, guys, I'm so hungry, man. Right after this, I will make some good dinner. I will make some spinach, some fish, and some potatoes. Actually, quite healthy. Damn, look at me. Look at me. Not defending that one. Hope you can just get the walk, but like, you know, you can jam a lot. You will be aggressive on the button. Just gonna give that one up. Shitty hands all around. Question is, how do we get abused if you limp this? Probably pretty hard. I think I would have limped it in the end anyhow with 15 bigs. 4-6 off. Queen 7 suited, not gonna be 3-bet jam this. He's aggressive as hell, man. He's just opening everything right now. But he has the most chips, so it's fine. We already made 40 euros in KO, so right now we made like 125 euros in this tournament. Ooh, 3-bet. So hope he goes for the 4-bet jam. Nope, he folds it. Damn. We just have to be patient here, guys. There's just not much we can do with my stack, but fold and fold and fold and fold and fold. Big all in here for 36 bigs effective. Alright. He threw it again, he's aggressive here. Just abuses the fact that I'm super short and these guys don't want to bust here. Maple Getty goes for the 4-bet jam and Carter Mundix wakes up with a hand, that would be sweet. Nope. He just continues abusing the tail, which is totally fine with me, you know. With my stack, there's just not much I want to do. I just want to wait, hope they knock each other out. Let's hope we get a walk here, or at least a limp, man. 8-9 off. Sucks to be folding that. Sucks to be folding that. Would have loved to see a flop. Queen 7 suited, your champ line was blind, but probably we're just not getting the spot here. Katamonix is just cruising. Oh, he is opening it up. Crotechia. No idea what that means. Maybe I just said something really bad here. Hope that's not the case. My French is really, really bad. Where are these guys from? Millionaire U? Like, how can you see where they're from? Sometimes you see it and sometimes you don't. You know, here you see it. Nijmegen. I don't think. Maybe they block it or something. I didn't follow the action along here. That's King 9. Did you check the A5 twice there? Let's see. Oh shit, we got 9s and FT, guys. Oh, come on. Why doesn't he open? No, we have 10 bigs and we just have to open champ. It kind of sucks. I would have loved to 3-bet champ it. But you know. Oh shit, we can still get ice white here. Let's hold. No ace. No ace. No check. Yes, guys. 35k, important double up. Not last in chips anymore. We get it. Peter Swaggart's still in the chat. Big shout out to my man. Alright, gonna review the hand now over here. Defends the big. He checks it, checks it, and he goes for a small bet and costs with h5. I think that's reasonable, even though I prefer a bet on the turn there. But that's like the standard line. Actually, it's quite an interesting line to check there. Not bad, I mean. Alright, you see an open here? So the only second shortest now, but look at his booty, man, 73 euros. Oh shit, look at his short bounty, because he was like short the entire time, and like small bounty, he was short the entire time and couldn't hunt much. Queen 9 we will defend now for 22 bigs. Like we even with that guy. Not a bad spot, you guys. You can certainly make a comeback. Let's flop good here, you know, like the king check 10 board, that would be sweet. 10 is there, but that's about it. So we are just gonna tank a little bit before we check, just make it a little bit more likely that he will check it back. And we can realize some of our equity, even though we don't have much. Queen check here, easy champ line was blind. This would be interesting. I will call him, though he will champ a lot in the big blind, but just a little bit too choosy to come along here. And we have no mana, two overcards, guys. We are gonna check it here. And we have to call that if these two guys fold. If they call. I think if they call, given ICM, we have to fold, but like, we have just have to call that. 17k into 33k, given 2-1, and a shot at a bounty. We have to call this. And we can be ahead here, he calls as well. Man, this is a pretty sick spot here. This is a pretty sick spot, man. Holy fuck, dude. 3 minutes of time back, okay, I just think this through. So, if we bust, we get a lead of 30 euros. We have 8 as an out and a king, guaranteed. A queen and a check might be an out, it's not guaranteed though. We get a booty as well. Yeah, I think we just have to go with it here. I think we have to go with it here with the queen check. Yeah, we have to go with it here with the booty equity, I think. And the good thing is, like, if you lose to him, it's not that bad even because we still make a ladder, you know, as long as he doesn't win the hand. So, yeah, I think we have to go with it here. Alright, come on. Hold. Boom! Oh my god, he has kings! He flatted kings pre! Oh my god, guys! Oh my god, so lucky! We have the chip lead and the biggest bounty in the house! Oh my god, getting lucky! Oh god, I folded king 3, I'm a moron! I'm a moron! No, why did I fold the king 3, man? My kissing dropped off. Okay, we wouldn't have gotten that one either. Wow, he just jammed the fan line. Holy shit, guys! Alright, he stays alive, I like that. Holy moly, so sick. Oh my god, guys, 105, guaranteed 200 euros in this tournament. 112 euros in payouts, plus even more here in the booties. Wow, what a sick spot here. And Queens win it, man, he's right back into it. Which is okay, man. Which is okay. I mean, we sucked out of him there with the Kings. I didn't put him on Kings, it was weird that he just called, you know? Maybe it's a mistake even, but... Because... It's just weird that he calls, but I just read the call as well as an all-in, you know? I thought, like, if he calls there, he might just be all-in, and... Yeah. What did the other guy champ, by the way? He champed ace 9. No, he didn't champ. That was the hand before where we doubled. King 10 here, and the other guy had kings. So our kings were completely blocked. We had one out as a king, man. How much equity did we have there? Let's look over this, man. So you open champs king 10, perfectly fine. But like, look at this, man. 27k into 50k, getting 2-1 here, plus shotted bounties, and yeah, I just thought he would get like 8s and 9s in pre, so I thought, like, you know, he doesn't have a set here, or 7s even, so we should be like, even then we have 21% here. Obviously, that's pretty lucky that we get there. But damn, son, that was a sick hand. That was a sick hand, guys. Now we have 50 bigs. We are the chip leader. Let's start crushing here. This C-bet will not work like super often, but I think it will just work slightly often enough to make it profitable. And we take it on 90k. Wow. What a sick hand, man. Luckbox Lero, guys. Luckbox Lero. Through the jam here. With the second biggest bounty here. King Queen versus 9s. That should be a snap call. Not really why he tanked. Does he get there again? Nope. Unlucky. GG, man. Feel a little bit dirty for that Sagot on his king. So I mean, I like that he traps it there. But yeah. Now we three-handed team. And we're all pretty even. He's a little bit shorter than us two. And yeah, we guaranteed 170 euros plus 75 KO, so 250 euro. Nice little profit here. But we want more than that, guys. We want to get that gold. Because first, that's so important is, once again, because you get your own bounty. So right now, like, let's see. Well, we'll see later. Like, if we get this, we have 60 euros or 150 euros. Yeah. Just really, like, 230 euros we get extra here if we make first. So, like, 600 euros up top. Never fire out one C-bet. Just getting off like all the king, queen, check, 10 type hands. Because like, I don't know, when he snap calls like that, I don't think he usually has too much on the board. But he raises us and takes it down. Let's play good three-handed, guys. We are pretty deep, all 50 bigs. Not like my special strength there, but, you know, just play good poker, try our best, be focused, most importantly. Alright. It's a really nice turn, gonna bet it big. And take it down. Alright. Just weird, man, I hate to play that. Alright, this would be 3-bet for me now. With the ace blocker and block 7s as well, which is like not too important, obviously. Oh, he's thinking about it. Maybe he comes in for the 4-bet. Nope. Taking that one down. 95k, back in the chip lead. Nice one. Opening the queen jack here on the button. Do we call a 3-bet? Probably, if it's not too big. Queen jack in position. Off. 3 is a big blind. He did that before. I think we call here. And it flops nice. Alright, it's a good flop. With the backdoor diamonds as well. We're gonna be calling the bet here on the flop. Let's hit a check or a queen on the turn or a diamond. Alright, diamond. If he jams it here, man, it will be awkward. It will be so awkward for us. Yeah. I think I'll pay this off though. Come on. We had 30% versus kings, you know, and if we give him a bluff there, it would be quite good. Damn it. Damn it! Would have been sick if he sucked out there again. So he just threw back kings. But you know, the flop is just too good. And I think like a lot of hands that he has have diamonds are like just like betting small in the turn or checking it. So I think we like usually our queen of diamonds is live or either our check is live. And that was the case here, so we had 30% versus kings. But if you give him a bluff there, like ace diamonds with the ace of hearts or something, you know, we like have, we are suddenly the favorite. And yeah, action here, pretty crazy. Hopefully they just get it in. I would love that now as a short stack. Damn. Oh shit, ace. Oh, come on. Ah, oh, didn't pair the board. Damn it. Wow, really bad to get it in here with ace nine. Now we are two shorties and one big stack. He just open champs 20 now. Alright, he seems like. Alright, so we get abused for the checks open here and get jammed on. No action with the checks, damn it. Would have been a good spot to double and make a comeback here. Not a finger 7 loose. Like, we are playing for like a 60 euro ladder now, so there will be some ICM implication for the both of us. Gonna limp the king for suited. Doesn't raise it. I'm gonna check the flop here. And give it up. Blinds are going up now. That means we drop to, I don't know, like 17 bigs, something like that. Ace queen here will be a race call. We will jam like ace 8 and all the bullshit on us, and here also. But we just take it down again, damn it. No action with the good hands here. That sucks. Alright, let's hope he calls. Snap folds it though. Couldn't you just jam at the last two hands we opened? Damn it. Sixes would be through a jam here. If he opened jams. Alright, blind was blind. For 18. I will actually limp this. Limp jam it. It would be awkward if he jams because we have to call, but like open jamming is fine here, but like with this deck I think we can do some raises. Wow, that's a flop, guys, that's a flop. Gonna be betting big here on the flop. Hope he just sticks in with queen 5 or pocket 5s. But he jams that pre, no, he doesn't have pocket 5s. So he doesn't have 8-9 or 4-3, because he can definitely have those. We're gonna be betting again on the turn here. And jam that river. If he has a straight, good for him, but with our set here, blind versus blind, we get always called by a queen here, and yeah. Not always called, but we get called quite often here. Nope, we take it down, guys, but good pot, up to 45k here. We'll raise the a6 here. And can't call the jam. Damn it, now we get abused and we don't have the good hands anymore. No. I think we jam the force for 23 here. There's a button open. Take it down. 46k here. Making a little bit of a comeback, you know. Just a little small one. Got a fold here. He's been open jamming like a lot. Queen 8 suited here. Gonna be calling. And draw heavy board here. I think we just call. Hopefully we see like, come on, eight of clubs on the turn. It's not great here, the 9 of clubs. It's also not a great river. I think we check call it though. Hopefully it doesn't bet like 14k. I think we just have to pay that off. Yes! And that's why check called the river, team. That's why check called the river there with the queen 8. Sweet one. Stacking up here, stacking up. I'll fold this one. We're up to 38 bigs. You know, it's good to like check call the 8. And, you know, I used to like bet it out a decent amount there, which is just not good. Especially like in that spot where he will just bluff a lot there. Alright, that's good, man, that's good. Making things happen here. I would start 2.5xing it again versus him. He just abused our limbs a little bit too much, I think. Gonna go for a small c-bet here and double barrel it all the time here on basically every turn. Especially that one. And hopefully we hit the spade in the river. Nope, just gonna check it and give up and pray he has 5-3. He has deuce 4. Damn it. Crazy, called it 2.5x with deuce 4 there. Wild. Get 3 bet here. Really small. Really small, actually. I think we have to call this. With a shitty hand like that. Could also 4 bet jam, but I don't know, I think this is value heavy, actually. And just fold it here on the flop. We just hope to flop a monster or like a good draw. Which we don't have actually ever. Like almost ever. I know, man, the sizing is just too small for me to fold there, I feel. Gonna call. And gonna check call the flop here. He checks it back, interesting. Gonna check again. And gonna check again and hope he beat like a deuce here. We do. Maybe a 3 as well. See what he had there. He had queen 8. Just doesn't see bet it. He seems also weird, man. Those guys are making some weird moves. The problem is like he can abuse us pretty hard. He is maybe shouldn't even limp to 5-4. You'll just see. The last time he limped, he 3x'd. So maybe he sees that this is actually a good strategy versus us. Because of the 3 like limp folds as well. Yep. So we definitely limp all of our good hands now that he the 6s earlier. We saw the raises here from him. He's down to 14 bigs. He's pretty short, but he still has this really, really small booty. Alright, king 3 here with the small bounty. Gonna be calling. Good flop. Once more flop top pair. He just seems to be c-betting not always, man. The queen 8 was a real check. We're gonna call. So hit the 3 on the turn. It's a decent turn. You know, it doesn't change much. Gonna check it. And I will call another bet and maybe fold the river. Just says, it's a dirty bet, man. Sets up that river jam, but easy call for us with the king. And everything breaks, I think we gotta check card it now. Alright. Yeah, I think we just have to call down there with the king when everything breaks. Yeah, GG. GG guys, that was a wild wild runs there. I hope you enjoyed the video guys. It's a little bit different this time. I didn't edit much, but yeah, if you watch through till here, man, definitely tell it to me in the comments. I'm in London now guys, so there will be uploads from yesterday's from last week. I hope you enjoy them. So thanks for hanging out, all of you guys. I wish you all the best of luck while I'm gone. I hope I can win some live tournaments in London, and yeah, catch you in a week. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for hanging out, guys. Good luck.